pastor of the church. Thanks for coming. And I hope your foot is ready to start tapping. And your hands are ready to start clapping. Now, I tell people who go to our church regularly, don't look at me to try and see if you should clap or not. I am rhythmically challenged. So if I clap, I will mess everybody up. In fact, I had somebody say to me one time, things don't clap, you're messing the whole section up. And so I just listen, and I'll smile and stuff, but I won't clap, except for applause. But you guys can clap along, you can tap your foot or whatever you want to do. And James Creek Road Band is from Elgin area, Zion, Illinois. And we've got some White Sox fans up here. We've got some Cubs fans up here. And this weekend has been a rivalry of sorts. And they've been having some conversations, right, on the trip. But anyway, they still are all people who love Jesus. So, and that's a big consolation prize if you love the Cubs. So, at any rate, we're glad they're here. And I'm not going to stick around for the whole concert because some of you know I do a lot of funerals and I've got a funeral to do. So I've got a sad time, but you guys have a joyful time. My wife will be up here for the offering and for closing prayer. But let's give the James Creek Road Band a big round of applause. And thank you for being here. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. Thanks for coming out. We are very glad to be up here in Janesville this afternoon and playing some good gospel music and worshiping together, praising the Lord together. We are thankful to be playing indoors in air conditioning. The last couple weeks, last weekend we were at a festival in Michigan, and then we turned around and played on Saturday in Brooklyn, Wisconsin, not too far from here, on Sunday, I'm sorry.
It melted your hair away.
And then we played Thursday night at a local park down in Zion, and it was just smoking out there. And we played for a birthday party yesterday, and it was smoking out yesterday. So we are very thankful to be someplace cool and dry. We're going to do some, talking to David. David Ashley is the one who contacted me, and we've been conversing by email, and have been playing some of the music from our CD, and we're going to do a lot of that stuff here this afternoon, and a few maybe you haven't heard, or this is one from the CD we've been doing a long time, and it's got a really good message. It's called Still on the Rock.
This home that I'm building is founded on love. Its timbers are treated with things from above. My faith in it standing, I nailed it with prayer. Now Jesus, my Savior, abides with me there.
When the snow ain't flying, the roads ain't bad.
There we go.
Yeah, then we have, then it ain't Cubs Sox no more. Then it's Packers Bears, because I'm the only Packers fan in the bunch. So.
Woo!
I am amongst my people.
That's why you booked so many jobs in Wisconsin.
Yeah, it doesn't hurt.
We never play in the city of Chicago, and I know why.
All right, we're going to do a song that it's new to us, but it's certainly not a new song. And for those of you who's kind of bluegrass fans, it's an old Flatten Stroke song. It's called Talking All Over With Him.
One, two, three.
The hot hotbed of bluegrass music is Mr. Bruce Goss from Canada.
Newfoundland.
Oh, I knew it was one of them crazy names up there way up north. Way on the northeast side, right?
Yeah, Canada's north.
Pretty good for me.
That's what happens when you get lost for words, I guess.
Charlie got D's in geography.
Jesus Savior, piloting over life, tempestuous sea, unknown way before me, highly brought and treacherous shore. Charted compass came in. Jesus Savior, pilot me. When at last I near the shore and the fearful breakers roar, with me and my peaceful rest, then why?
As you guys know, we've got a couple CDs we cut, both of them in Nashville, Tennessee, over the last 4 or 5 years now. The first one we did was pretty much straight bluegrass. There's a couple gospel songs on there, but the last one we did about 2.5 years ago or so was all gospel, and we were pretty proud of that, if that's okay to say, but it turned out pretty good. And with the exception of the fiddle on there that we got, for those of you who might, again, know bluegrass music, there's a gentleman named Jim Van Cleve. He plays with a group called Mountain Heart that you might see on the Opry or on TV every once in a while with some stuff. Just a really good guy and an awesome fiddle player that did the fiddle work for us. But everything else was us, you know. A little repaired. You get to do it over if you make a mistake, unlike up here. And there was a couple mistakes along the way. We're good. Bruce made several, but who's counting? We're the one that if you were going to play your harmony. We're going to do what we have fun with. Let's do this. This is off the CD, too. It's called The Better Deal Down.
A song that tells a little bit of a story, and I'm sure you've heard the story many times in the scripture. So this one's called
Out of Pressure.
Out of Pressure on the banjo player. It's called My Name is Judas.
So I hung myself in the
fan of this. People right here saw it before, but Karen is my sister. That makes Charlie my brother-in-law, I think.
And you're proud of
that? I'm very proud of that. Karen and Charlie were high school sweethearts. That's how they met. Karen was a sophomore, and Charlie was a school janitor at the time. Well, that's the truth. That's what you're supposed to do. I don't know what he said. Larry Grimes got called for duty, the bass player back here, Larry got called for jury duty this past week. And he went in and told the judge, he goes, I can't stay for this. I can't be gone from my job that long. I just can't do it. And the judge says, well, can your boss make it without you? And Larry says, well, of course, but I don't want him to know that. All right, we're going to do an old Stanley, but it's time to play. Do an old Stanley Brothers song. This is called Willie Wait a Little Long.
Much to play about, and that there's a lot of joy in serving you. We thank you that we are able to celebrate that together today, and we pray that you'll help us have a more of a spring in our step as we leave here this afternoon to go and share your love with those around us. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Spirit, but they live by what they see. Never trusting their own Yep.
My glasses. He's going to have to start typing them words a little bit bigger.
Like we said, you're closer to it than we are.
Other side of this line. We're in the area.
We're going to do a song, Larry. We're over here. We're going to tell you a little bit about it. So he gets his banjo ready to go.
All right, Bruce is normally the songwriter of the band. Bruce has written a ton of songs, and some that we do, some that he won't let us do. He won't even let us hear. I've written a couple, and they're on the gospel album. This one, like a lot of people, I came to know the Lord out of something basic, kind of in tragedy that God turned around and used in a positive way. At 16 years old, I had just turned 17. I had a cousin who was 4 months younger than me. And the last day of school, our junior year in high school, she was killed in a car wreck. And although I had been to church and been to Sunday school and kind of stuff too, I still hadn't made that decision. And after losing her, I remember thinking, once I made that decision about, there's so much pain in this world, and in all likelihood, you're going to have to say goodbye to a lot of friends and family members that you're very close to. And if you didn't think, if there wasn't that promise that there was something on the other side, that you're going to get to see your friends and family again, and you're going to get to see the Lord, why would you even go through, you know, what you're going to go through here? So that's kind of the basis of this song. It's a driving bluegrass song, but that's kind of the message behind it. It's called The Other Side of This Life.
1, 2, 3.
Lewis family song. I should say, Karen and I grew up in listening and getting to play this kind of music very early on. My dad had a bluegrass band from before the time we were born.
Stand like this right here.
And he came up from Mississippi and for the work up north and brought that kind of music with him. And my mom and dad came up today with us, so give them a nice hand for it. Every Sunday evening is usually our practice night, so no practice tonight, Mom. We are all coming over for supper. Yeah, my mom's our biggest fan. We could be playing in five different keys, all out of time, everything else. Mom said, "You guys sounded really good today." That's what Mom's supposed to do. That's all right. This is called "Flight Leaving Soon."
Oh, good.
Thank you.
trying to find things to say when Larry's switching instruments, and sometimes it's all fun, but it gets pretty nasty. It's my time to get even for all the short jokes and the bald jokes. For the last 6 weeks, I've heard bald jokes, short jokes. Car seat jokes. I forgot my car seat, that's why I was late. You know how many times I've heard that? Everywhere we go. It's like, find something else to joke about.
I didn't realize you were so sensitive, Rob. I'll stop.
Okay, find another joke.
All right.
You got your guitar?
I do, I'm ready.
Is it in tune?
Close enough. This is a song I heard my dad and my Aunt Sue sing years ago. It's not by anybody famous, but I always liked the words and kind of dug it back out here. It's called How Great Is My God. That was a dramatic pause.
Well, I kicked this one. Let's see.
All right, no more.
There you go.
I gotta get this man.
The moon and the stars, the path he trod, the sheep and the oxen, the peace of the field, all of these wonders let you know that he's real. How great is my God? How great his word. He's the greatest man that ever was heard. He rolled back the water of the rugged Red Sea. And he said, I'm gonna lead you. Put your trust in me. His birth.
That was good.
Here it comes now.
Drinking my water.
I can tell you about Charlie. Charlie was going through a rough time here recently, so he went to one of these big bookstores, like Borders or something like that, one of the big gigantic superstores, and he walked up to the cashier and said, can you tell me where the self-help section is? And she said, wouldn't that defeat the purpose? Some of you guys on the way home, that's going to hit you, and you're going to just have to pull over and laugh. Maybe I'll go back to the short jokes.
I like that one.
Anybody here from the South? Roots? Tennessee, Alabama, Mississippi?
Southern California?
Not what I was thinking of, but that's okay.
Carolina.
Back
to do with Carolina.
You from the South? What part of South are you from?
South Carolina.
All right. Did you see this guy that when he walked by, he's got a wrestling shirt on and he walks like
I'm going to be a man.
Actually, I think I wouldn't want to fight him myself.
Oh, man, and just because he's short, leave him alone.
No, he's you like a wrestler. Are you a wrestler? So you have to tell him.
Down where by where my dad's from, and it's the pictures on our gospel CD is where all my grandparents are buried and all my relatives on my dad's side. It's always been kind of a special place, but the church is kind of fallen down and not in the condition it used to be. And that's kind of what this song's about. It's called God Is Here.
All right, we're going to get things changed around. We're going to be an all vocal thing here tonight, Dylan. And at this time, we're going to thank the sound guys back there. You did a fine job. That's music to my ears right there.
How many of you have heard much bluegrass in your life? Good. I hope you're enjoying it today. We will enjoy it. We've got a beautiful church here and a beautiful congregation and very nice people. We really appreciate you having us. We enjoy this environment as much or better than anything we do. And we really appreciate you guys coming.
Well, you know, we're pretty informal. We've known each other all of our lives. If we're not family, we've been friends for years, but we have a good time here together. So we hope you enjoy the music and laugh along with us and we kind of joke around each other. Really, Bruce and Larry are pretty talented guys. Charlie and I were lucky to get to know
you. Speak for yourself.
Well, actually, Larry, Bruce, and Larry are pretty talented guys. The last 2 or 3 weeks, we wouldn't either. We've had a good time. We enjoy each other's company as well as singing the music. So, you guys ready?
Yeah, we're gonna do this one and one more, and we're gonna call it a day and head back south for us. So, David, thank you for contacting me and getting us up here. We really appreciate it.
Hit me a chord, dear friend.
Listen to me, sinner. Don't you wanna go? For some days coming back again, you know. If that wrong ain't right, you'll be lost in sin.
Get in line, brother.
He will take you in. Now get in line, brother, if you want to go home. Get on your knees and right that wrong. Soon you'll be singing that old time song.
Get in line, brother,
if you want to go home. Well, let me tell you, Satan, I have right in there. I got a one-way ticket and I'm going home. I ain't got no worries while I sing this song.
Get in line, brother.
If you want to go home. Well, get in line, brother. If you want to go home. Get on your knees and righten that wrong. Soon you'll be singing that old-time song.
Get in line, brother.
If you want to go home. Well, let me tell you, brother, just how. Then you'll know the love of God is real, and you'll be praying while I sing this song.
Get in line, brother,
if you want to go home. Well, get in line, brother, if you want to go home. Get on your knees and righten that wrong. Soon you'll be singing that old-time song.
Get in line, brother,
if you want to go home.
Thank you. What he was singing, but that's what he's trying to live. I know for me it's much easier to sing about God's love on Sunday morning than it is to live about it and live it and show it on Monday morning. And the words of the song, God Lives Here, I think let's stand together and let's pray that our neighbors and our co-workers will see that God lives here in our lives this coming week. So let's stand and pray a blessing. Lord, thank you that you don't just live here in our church, but you live in our hearts, and you've decided to make us your temple, and that's just pretty amazing. So we pray for your blessing as the band travels home. We pray for us as we go back into our everyday world, that for all of us, God, we'll see in our lives that you live here. Help us to show that love to those around us in increasing ways. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you.